Israeli troops surrounding the Gaza Strip. Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu asks if they're ready because the next stage is coming. Over the border, tens of thousands of Gazans flee for their lives in cars, carts, on foot, running out of time.
In the morning, in the night, there's lots of bombing. We are children. It's not right to do that to children.
Israel dropped leaflets over Gaza City, ordering more than half the population to move south within 24 hours. That deadline has now passed.
Our house was bombed. We left with our clothes and without anything. I want to return to my home. I have no other place.
This is ethnic cleansing. This is a crime against humanity. This needs to be stopped.
Now Israel stands accused of bombing civilians as they fled. This a scene of total carnage. The full aftermath too graphic to show. 70 people killed, including children as young as two, after a convoy of vehicles travelling on a road marked safe was struck by a deadly missile. Survivors rush to hospitals that are already overwhelmed.
Unless there is respite, there is going to be an infectious diseases public health catastrophe in the hospital. The bodies are stacked up. People are too afraid to bury their dead.
As airstrikes continue to pound Gaza and Israel prepares for a ground invasion, the Australian government has confirmed repatriation flights, which were cancelled, will hopefully resume today.
I want to trust in my other home that they are going to do what they're saying they're going to do and try and get us out.
850 Australians have left Israel and the Palestinian territories, another 20 trying to escape Gaza. Hundreds of foreign nationals who massed at the Rafah crossing to try to flee to Egypt, forced to give up. For now, the only way out of Gaza is shut.
I'm, like, really in fear, and, like, every time I just have to have the thought of me dying in a bomb in Gaza. Like, it's not a good thing. And, like, every place I go run away, and I just find bombs, and I find dead people. And, like, maybe one day I'll end up like them, but it's a really scary thing for me.
10 News First's John Paul Gonzo is in southern Israel, close to the Gaza border. John Paul, how close is a ground invasion?
Well, Sarah, from what we're seeing here on the ground, it certainly appears to be imminent. A lot of build-up of troops and tanks close to the border here with Gaza in southern Israel. Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu has been meeting with troops, telling them that the next stage is coming, promising a land, air and sea invasion of Gaza. So exactly when that happens, no exact timings yet confirmed. But there are reports tonight that the ground offensive has been delayed because of the weather. We've seen some cloudy, overcast conditions, and that would have made it very hard for Israeli air forces to provide cover for ground crews going in. So that has been delayed. I mean, as you can see here, military equipment on the move, soldiers and troops coming through. So certainly something is coming, and it is coming very soon.
How is the Israeli government responding to these claims that civilians have actually been bombed while they were trying to follow those corridors out of northern Gaza heading south?
Well, Hamish, it has rejected those accusations that it has been harming Palestinian civilians trying to escape. But we have seen dozens and dozens killed on what were supposed to be safe routes, supposedly organised by the Israeli Defence Forces. People in Gaza, in the north, who have been moving to the south, had been given an extension on that deadline to leave. But many just simply don't want to. They're too scared or unwilling to because of those attacks. Israel has also accused Hamas of trying to block people from leaving and targeting civilians as well.
There are a lot of Australians who are desperate to come home, and some hope that the repatriation flights will resume. You've been talking to people. How are they coping?
Well, they're definitely very anxious, but at this stage, they are still confident that they will be able to get out. The concern many have, though, is actually where they'll end up going. That first repatriation flight went to London, but we understand some flights are due to take off today on civilian and military aircraft, but they are going to Dubai. And a few of the Australians I've spoken to say they are reluctant to get on those flights and go to Dubai, given everything that's happening. Still, the Aussies say that they don't feel abandoned yet by DFAT, and they feel like the government is doing everything at the moment in their power to get them home. We know there was quite a few hundred Australians who had expressed their interest to leave and get out, particularly as the military situation here intensifies.
John Paul Gonzo, please stay safe. We'll see you soon.
Thanks, guys.
Let's go to Rami Swailem, who lives near Gaza City. While others are evacuating, Rami and at least five other families in his building have decided to stay put. Rami, are you safe there with your family?
To some extent, there's no safer place here in Gaza. Even those who, two days ago, when they asked those people to evacuate, they shell the different of the many people that were killed, about 70, I think. 70 people were killed during the evacuation process in their way to the south of Gaza. So there is no safer place here, really. I mean, even the hospitals, there's no safer place here.
Rami, the Israeli military is being really clear. They're saying to everyone in the northern part of the Gaza Strip, and that's where you are, you're in the northernmost bit of the Strip, to go south because they're going to bomb, possibly conduct a ground invasion in the north and destroy everything that Hamas has in terms of infrastructure and weaponry. Why don't you get out of there while you have the opportunity?
There is no safer place, I told you. Even those who has foreign passports to go outside Gaza, they are not allowed to do to go there. Nothing to say, to be said except that as Gazans, we prefer to stay at our homes, and even if we at risk, because every place in Gaza is at risk, and even you can die any moment, any time.
If you're staying where you are and a ground offensive is coming and Israel says it's preparing for a long campaign, are you ready for what's to come?
What kind of being ready? There's nothing. We Palestinians, we love to live in dignity and peace. But what to be ready? To be ready for what? We don't have. This is the eighth day. There is no electricity, no water, drinkable water, no internet. Even it is very bad. I came here to my family, to my father's house, including my sisters and their siblings and others. We are about 40 here in the same building. To stay, just it's a kind of being safety emotionally and in our feelings. But it is really, we are putting ourselves at the shilling because the shilling is everywhere at the Gaza Strip.
Rami, stay safe. Thanks so much for speaking to us tonight.
Thank you.